They just restarted there, and I was messing around with something else while I had it going at the green flag. Round and round in here we go. 25 to go. Kick it back. Come on, Harvick. I was looking down at something on my phone. Happened to look up, but then swing a green flag. Sorry about that. I had it going. Nice job. Where you at, Harvick? Eighth place.
Truex trying to drive away as they're all bottled up for third place.
Chase Elliott back there working the bottom. We've seen how strong his car is on the short runs.
The importance, I can take it all back to the importance of the truth. Joey Logano at 22, he chose the bottom. And I said it, I knew if that 19 could get established into his right rear to the outside of him in a preferred line, he was going to take the lead, and he sure enough did. Edward Camaro is battling for fifth. Side by side just in front of them. What a match resolved in favor of Hamlin. Great bounce back from both of those cars, actually. The 9 car getting caught on speeding on pit road a couple times, as well as the 5. To be in the hunt still, running 5th and 6th is pretty amazing. Start in the back. Now the 300 cars that started this race in the back due to inspection issues are now 5th, 6th, and 7th.
Got plenty of practice passing people today.
Right. Yeah, if they gave passing points like they will for the heats of Bristol, Kyle Larson would be miles ahead.
A lap ahead.
Still pounding. Here he comes in the frame with Harvick side by side. And Martin Truex out front just ran his fastest lap of the day.
Time to go, boys.
What a rebound for this 10 and Eric down the road. I thought when he got caught speed on pit road, his day was over. Certainly not the case. Bounce back needed a big day. Is right there to capture that.
Ryan Blaney ran well early, but here he is in 11th place.
Hard to keep up with this racetrack, Mike. I mean, it's changed a good bit right now. You know, you got the sun setting, but I think that traction compound, the balance of the cars have just really, you know, changed throughout this day. And you've seen a lot of cars kind of be really strong at some portion of the race, and then others be strong at another. Some strong in the short runs, some on the long runs. But it's been a great race.
Your comment right there brings me back to what we talked about at the top of the show. The importance of this traction compound, why we put this traction compound on there. In my opinion, it creates this environment where you're always chasing the racetrack, and then when the time's right, at the end of the race, when you need to be side-by-side racing, it creates just that.
Atlanta next Sunday on the mile and a half, and in 2 weeks, we go on the dirt race.
Talk about a track that's going to change.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, these two teammates right here at Hendrick Motorsports, Kyle Larson of 5, Chase Elliott, the 9. They are working every lane, trying. You got Larson working the 2 car of Keselowski, trying to get by him, and the 9 working the bottom, working every different thing he can. And then Larson's up top, really pushing the limits, or at least he was the last lap, really pushing the limits of that traction compound as it's starting to roll up. I think Brad started really watching what those guys are doing behind him. Now he starts moving up a little bit more.
And listen, when you say that, look where they're all running. Not in that traction compound anymore. On the bottom of the racetrack.
Ooh, did Cole Custer get the wall?
Yeah.
At some point, hard.
Uh-oh.
And did he have help? We'll have a look back and see. Custer in the 41.
I don't know if he was getting passed by the 1. Uh-oh.
Ooh.
He tried to slide up there in that gap, and then Bubba tried to cross him over and made contact.
Tried with Kurt Busch for this one. We are still green.
I mean, Clint, yeah, I look at that hole He started to fill that gap. I don't know if his spotter said something to him, and then he hesitated, and as soon as he hesitated was when Bubba Wallace was making that move.
Yeah, it's just kind of a timing thing. We saw that yesterday, as a matter of fact. The guy was coming up from the bottom. It's a tough vantage point on a lot of things. You and the car trying to see if you're clear. And then the spotter. This is one unique thing about this racetrack for everybody involved, you know, is these guys are going off into turn one on a restart, 3, 4, 5 wide. Sometimes I think we saw as much as 6 wide yesterday in that Xfinity race. That vantage point from the spotter is not good at all. Same thing coming off of 2. Fourth place here, Brad Keselowski still holding back the 2 Hendrick cars, or at least staying out in front of them. Let's put it that way.
I think the 9 of Chase Elliott's a little bit better than Larson right now. I don't know what adjustments are in this last set of tires, but it just doesn't seem like Larson's car's quite as quick as it has been. To his rear bumper, loose the nut. Now Larson might be a little bit too high. Yeah, he's going to have to give way.
Cut up in that marbles, exactly what you just said, Jeff. Got up too high. 9 turned underneath them. But today will be the day that the usual suspects showed up in force. 6 of the top 7 spots occupied by arguably 6 of the top stars in the sport. That's a debris right there. The backstretch is going to be interesting to see what kind of debris that is. We know it's off.
There's a usual suspect. You saw that 4 car coming into the picture. You have moved into the TV world. Okay. I heard that.
Hey. Tough day for Kyle Busch. He's a lap down after some contact from Ross Chastain.
There he 42. Flew.
No contact there.
Yeah, Ross, take some advice. Don't race him. Where you are right now.
Not today.
Live. Another
no, day. Turner has it. The 18 was a little bit heated on his radio. Might want to let him go.
What I tell Ross right now is stick your finger in a rattlesnake's mouth. You can't get mad because it bites you.
Truex trying for his first Phoenix win. He has 2 seconds at this racetrack. Has not visited victory lane. And he would be our sports 5th different winner.
Harvick.
Harvick getting a little antsy. He's looking to the low side. Nothing there against Kyle Larson.
Yeah, you can see Larson.
Congratulations, Caitlin, on your win earlier. I heard him say that.
Steps out, and that guys, once you see that, you pounce on it. You know, if you're Harvick,
there
you
will, boys, easy then.
More and more aggressive, because that's only going to force the issue of that car getting looser as Harvick goes by for that fifth,
get in. Spot.